At first, when I decided to carve Elsa, I thought about just letting her cape droop down along her back instead of it fluttering behind her like it does in the movie. But why even bother carving her then? It seems kind of boring. So I went hunting for a special piece of wood at a sawmill about 30 minutes outside of Austin. I found a surprisingly big piece of Eastern Red Cedar. One side of the log looked like rippling fabric already, so it kind of felt like it was meant to be. The guys there are really nice. They helped me cut it down and load it into my van. I started blocking out the basic shape with my largest chainsaw. At that stage, it's important to be a little bit careful, because with one stroke, you could remove all of your possibilities. When I was a kid, it was a lot harder to find examples of strong female characters in popular entertainment. The princesses needed a lot of rescuing. Women with power are almost always evil and manipulative, lashing out at other women, usually because they were prettier. In the end, the pretty girl always won, and the powerful women were vanquished. The overall message seemed to be this: beauty is more important than ability. My daughter Millie has much better animated role models. One thing I like about the new trend in entertainment is that there are more awesome female characters that can save themselves. Her favorite at the moment is Elsa from Frozen. Ever since she saw the movie, all she can talk about is how she wants special powers. After the bulk of the material was gone, I switched to a smaller chainsaw with a quarter-tip carving bar on it. I love this stage because it's lighter, I can go a lot faster, and start working on all the fun details. The less time it takes for my body to catch up with my brain, the better it is for the sculpting process. I think I'm gonna have to cut another arm for her, just for strength. I don't know if it's gonna be long enough, and even if it is, this part right here is gonna be short, so it'll break if it hits anything. So I think I'm gonna take another piece with the grain going that way, for strength, and sculpt the arm out of it. Before switching to my tiny detail saw, I used the angle grinder to smooth everything out to see what I still needed to clear away. And I was able to start getting some of the smaller details, like the ruffles and her cape. I used the Dremel to get the details in her hair, her face, around her fingers, and the snowflake patterns on the back of her cape. Because most of her body is so smooth, since she's from a cartoon, a lot of that detail had to be done with a paintbrush. After painting all of the base colors, like the different blues of her dress and then her skin color, I used a specialty metallic paint with an old scene painting brush to get the glittery effect on her bodice and on her cape. I used the same metallic paint on the high parts of her hair to create a shimmer and some highlights. This is a challenging carving because it's not a static image. She's twisting her body, there's movement in her cape, her arms are flung out in different directions. It's kind of a lot of pressure in some ways to be the mother of a daughter. I want her to have good examples, good role models in entertainment, but I also want to set a good example for her in work and in day-to-day life. I want her to be strong and independent and fearless. I want her to know how to make something out of nothing. It made me really happy to sculpt one of my daughter's heroes. I might not have ice powers, but I'm still doing everything I can to be a good role model.
If you enjoyed watching me make this Elsa sculpture, click on her to subscribe.